Welcome to Spring's Kids. I'm Rena and I'm so glad you're joining us today. Our Kinderchurch class is designed for kids ages 4 and 5. If you're in Winnipeg or Calgary, we would love to have you come and check it out. Every week, we have playtime where you can have fun with toys, make a craft, and make new friends. You can play exciting games and eat delicious snacks, dance along to fun music while you praise and worship God, and most importantly, we have a Bible lesson geared right to your age group so you can learn more about God, how much He loves you, and the amazing plan He has for your life. Here at Springs, our culture is to laugh. L stands for love. We should all love one another. A is for accept. We should accept each other and all be friends. And F stands for forgive. Ow. We all need to forgive one another.
Hi everyone, I'm Jenna. Excuse me, Miss Verena, that is all amazing, but can we show all the kids at home this week's lesson too?
Yeah, go for it.
Nice, we've got a super fun lesson this week. I can't wait for you to see it. Let's start by standing up and doing some praise and worship.
He's got a plan. He's got a,
yes he does.
He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. That's what I know. That's what I know. That's what I know. That's what I know.
Let's go.
I know that I can trust him.
Yeah.
I know that I can trust him.
Yeah.
No matter what the season.
Yeah.
His plans are for a reason.
Yeah.
I know they are good. I know they are best. The reason I know is because he said he's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. That's what I know.
Oh, that's what I know.
That's what I know.
Oh, that's what I know.
And when I'm feeling so sad. I know they are blessed. The reason I know is because I said he's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. That's what I know.
Oh, that's what I know.
That's what I know.
Oh, that's what I know.
Hey everyone, the Bible verse we're learning about this month will help us remember that God has amazing plans for us. It says, "For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord." Jeremiah 29:11. Now, let's all stand up, and can you guys say those words with me and do the actions too? You ready? For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. Jeremiah 29:11. Great job, friends. Let's keep learning about God's amazing plans and promises. I think our clubhouse friends are ready for today's lesson.
Hey, hey.
You know what time it is?
It's time to hear a story.
Your sad, sad friend Peyton here.
I was supposed to go play mini golf outside today, but when I woke up, I saw rain. I am sad because today is not going the way I want it to. How can I play mini golf outside today, even though it's raining? I know! I can use an umbrella while I play! Or I could put on all my rain gear to stay dry while I putt. What if I try to run around and around and around so fast that the rain can't catch me? It's Ollie!
Hello, Peyton. Is this rain bothering you?
Yes, Ollie. The rain is ruining my plans to play mini golf.
It's hard when plans don't go the way you want them to. But there may be a lesson for you. Listen to this story.
Just follow me through.
Follow me through. Follow me through. Ollie's got a Bible story for me and you.
Help, Ben.
That was so tough. Oh, hola, friends. I'm Luis, the handyman. Good to see you. Now, you would think being a handyman would make me pretty handy. But I can't get the lid off this jar. It's really difficult. Well, actually, doing something difficult is what today's story is about. Do you want to help me build it? Great. Let's put it on the story fence. Hammers up, little builders. Ready? Uno, dos, tres, hammer! Great job, little helpers. You can put your hammers down. Now we just need our story tools. Yep, we have everything we need. Okay, so today's true story from the Bible is about a person named Joseph. Joseph trusted God, and God had plans for him. Joseph also had a lot of older brothers. See if you can count them. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Wow! 10 brothers! Oh, that's a lot! One day, Joseph went to see his brothers who were taking care of the sheep. Uh-oh, look at the brothers' faces. Are they happy? Oh no, they were mad and very jealous. They didn't like that Joseph was wearing a special coat that their dad gave him, and they didn't get one. And Joseph was talking and talking about the dreams he had had, and his brothers were tired of listening. So they put Joseph into a hole and took his special coat. Oh, how do you think Joseph felt? That was so hard. But Joseph trusted God's plans for him. Then the brothers sent Joseph far away to the land of Egypt to work. Joseph didn't know if he would ever see his family again. Oh, it was so hard. But Joseph trusted God's plans for him. Joseph was a good worker, and he did the right thing. He was such a good worker that he was given a bigger job. But then, something bad happened. Everyone say, oh no! Ready? Oh no! People said Joseph did something bad that he didn't do, and he was put in jail. That was so hard. But do you think Joseph still trusted God? Yes! Everyone cheer for Joseph! Yay! Oh, hey there, Ollie. Tell me, Who has plans for you?
God has plans for you. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, who has plans for you?
God has plans for me. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. See you next time. Adios.
So there's your story. And it's all true. Joseph trusted God's plans, even when it was hard to do.
Thanks, Ollie.
Goodbye to you. Who? Who?
Even when it was hard, Joseph trusted God's plans. We can trust God's plans too, no matter what. I think I got the story. Did you get it? If you did, say got it. Get it?
Got it!
Good. Instead of being sad about the rain, I'm going to practice hitting the ball. See you next time. Bye!
No matter what, no matter what, Jesus' love for me will never change. No way, eh, He's always there, He's always there, taking care of me, and I believe, Jesus, you and me.
Guys, I'm so glad you joined us here today. We love learning about God, how much He loves us, and the amazing things He wants us to do. Did you know that you were loved so much by God that He sent His Son Jesus to die on a cross? He died, but He is such a hero. The best and true hero, that He defeated death, came back to life, and wants to be our best friend forever. How amazing is that? You know what? We're going to pray a super awesome prayer right now where we can ask Him to come into our hearts, be with us forever, and help us be superheroes too. With God in our hearts, we can live the best life possible. We can be brave, we can be strong, we can have joy and peace. He gives us healing when we're sick, is a friend when we're lonely, and gives us blessings so amazing we can't even imagine. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, thank you for dying on a cross for me and coming back to live, to be my forever friend. I want to live for you, follow you, and love you forever and ever. Please come into my heart, help me to learn and grow every single day, and be more like you. Amen. Wow, I'm so glad you prayed that prayer with me. If you don't have a Bible at home, you can ask your parents to contact us and we'll send you one. And don't forget to tell them to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss a thing. Have an awesome week. See you next time.